Hi, and welcome to Practical Pine, where today's show and every show is dedicated to something fun and practical and pine. Today we'll be building a Four Seasons planner with our tool of the day, the cordless screwdriver. Along with the cordless screwdriver, we have a drill driver. This allows you to pre-drill a hole and countersink the screw into the wood. Looking at our lumber inventory for today's project, we will be using 3 8-foot landscape timbers that you can buy at your local hardware store. Today's project will require a miter saw where all of your rings, which are octagons, will increase in size about 1/2 inch for every ring. Here you can see we'll be making 5 rings. The drywall screws we'll be using today are 2.5 inches long and 4 inches long. The rings will be assembled with the 2.5 inch screws, and the 4 inch screws are for final assembly. The compound miter saw will be your best friend for this project because you want all of your miters cut accurately at 22.5 degrees. After all, we are making octagons. The block of wood you see is clamped to the fence because every time we make a new ring, we have to move the block 1/2 inch to the right. Our first ring is very small, so these blocks are 5 inches in length. Make sure that you turn the landscape timber every cut to conserve wood. After 80 cuts with the miter saw, you'll have several stacks of wood that need to be made into the rings for the Four Seasons planner. We'll begin by making a dry fit with our 5-inch blocks. This is the ring that goes on the bottom of the Four Seasons planner. All of the rings will be assembled over here on the work table. You're going to provide a secure environment for your wood by using the clamps, and you want to use your screwdriver and the drill driver, because as you add pieces to every octagon, you want to put a 2.5 inch screw on the outside and a 2.5 inch screw on the inside. Now the ring assembly is one procedure that does take some time, so here you see us putting together another ring, but I think it's very important here to talk about the table height. You don't want to hurt your back while you're working on a project like this because you'll be doing this for about 2 hours, so we've chosen to put our work surface about waist high, and that way we have an ergonomically safe environment to do our woodworking. As you can see, we've saved the biggest ring for last. This is the 7-inch ring, and this is the ring that we attach the handle to. So when we're done fabricating this octagon, we will customize the length and shape of the handle. Thank you. After stealing some measurements from our existing planer, we take the wood over to the miter saw, and these cuts are 45 degrees. They're also very dangerous to make because they're very small, so make sure you're cutting them off of the end of an existing piece of wood. You will have some scraps, but it's better to save all your fingers. Now the handle is assembled in much the same way that we did all of our octagons, and you really don't even need a handle for this project if you don't desire one. But we're going to put one on our planer, so the first thing you need to do is attach this handle to the top ring. The 4-inch screws are the best way to attach the handle to the rings. You simply slide your ring off the edge of the table and attach the screws from the bottom. Way to go! The handle looks great, and now we're ready to do a dry fit with the other timbers. This is where you can be creative. You can have your timbers offset from one another, or you could simply align them and screw the pieces together. And last but not least, you'll want to debut your planter with flowers in it. So here you can see us cutting out a circle of styrofoam. We'll simply find an old hacksaw blade to get the job done. We have some artificial flowers on site, so we're going to poke the flowers into the styrofoam and then set it in the planter. And that way your flowers will be secure for all kinds of wind and weather. Now your Four Seasons planner is ready for display, and it will help you provide a fun and practical way to greet guests as they arrive at your home. That's all the time we have today on Practical Pine. Thanks for joining us. Watch again as we build something fun, practical, and probably out of pine.